Welcome to the afternoon nap session. To everyone else, I promise, you know, this is going to be short and sweet, and there's a lot of video and a little bit of me. So, you know, I think we'll transcend the post-lunch doldrum. You know, I want to thank iMedia and thank everyone here for having me and for taking part in this this summit, which I think has been incredibly enriching to this point. I'm Mark Walker, and I oversee Disney Interactive Entertainment. And Disney Interactive Entertainment is the business of DIMG across online, mobile, and social platforms. The video you just saw really gives you a glimpse of what we're up to, the things we think are important, the things we're really, really excited about. And so those are little tidbits. And you know, as we go, you'll see a lot more of some of this video. Our mission is pretty simple, pretty straightforward. It's to entertain people everywhere with world-class products and content that pushes the boundary of technology and of innovation and imagination. In the past year, we built a new team at Disney Interactive, and we're hard at work on critical projects. One is a complete end-to-end redesign of Disney.com, a redesign which will result in a site that's cleaner, that's more intuitive, simpler, faster, more personalized, and works as a multi-platform experience. We're launching several products on the moms and family side. You'll get a little taste of that, and including the integration of our recent acquisition of the Babbel Blogger Network, and the development of a suite of new strategic iOS apps. It's all coming together, and I'm pleased to say that you know, when you look across our networks and experiences today, we reach 100 million monthly uniques across all of our endpoints. I'm going to share our video strategy today, and I'm going to share how ultimately it's really a confluence of storytelling and smart distribution that adds up to what we have at Disney Interactive. So while the digital space requires kind of thinking out of the box, thinking beyond barriers, you know, in essence, you know, you can't throw out the old and just have the new. And really, our strategy there, therefore, for brand and entertainment, really focuses on established premises. We incorporate both the tried and true and innovative thinking around telling great stories, knowing our audience, adapting to the environment, and reaching our audience, you know, where they are. So we're committed to taking our stories to our audiences wherever they are, on Disney.com and beyond. So the first is telling great stories. And telling great stories can get really complicated very, very quickly. I mean, I'm sure you guys have all had the experience. You get a whole bunch of smart people in the room, and what do you end up with? You know, you end up with a Byzantine, convoluted a set of stories and narratives that really doesn't suit this format. So it's this reductionist approach, you know, having an essence, having a very simple story, which we think is critical to these digital formats. So in the digital space, a good story is a simple story. A great story is a straightforward story. As an example, we're given the pretty, you know, onerous and complicated task of generating awareness around the reopening of the Star Tours exhibit in the parks. You know, and really this, you know, really bringing together these two great brands and two great legacies around Star Wars and around Disney in the parks. Our creative solution really played off the answering a simple question. What would happen if the most evil person, the most evil entity in the entire universe went to the happiest place on Earth? And it's in this video that this dynamic is played out. So let's go to the video. Thank you. So that video was distributed across DMG and across all of our endpoints. And you know, net, including YouTube, and net, in a very short period of time, we reached 3 million views. We think the counter is actually driven much higher than that, because there's a lot of super distribution and social distribution of this content, which probably isn't accounted for. But the point is, you know, it was fun, it did justice to the brands, and it was really resonant with the audience. And it's a great story based on a very simple premise. The next example illustrates, you know, how stories and characters can be derived from the mobile space and from gaming. And we actually think this is going to be a very important source of new stories and new characters and new narratives moving forward. You know, it's happened, but I believe now it's only really reaching its potential. Outfit 7 is the maker of a very popular Talking Tom iOS app, and in fact, a universe of apps, which are described as talking friends. I think the overall distribution is something along the lines of 375 million downloads. And you know, I actually believe it's somewhat higher than that, because frankly, every time we talk to those guys, I mean, they've added like another 50 million. It's quite remarkable the network that they've created. So we're really excited about the brand equity that was developed by Outfit 7 and that resided in these characters. We saw a great opportunity to extend their stories, to explain to an audience, you know, where do these guys come from and what do they do and how really funny they are in essence. So let's take a look at the promo for the upcoming series that we've developed around the Outfit 7 Talking Friends cadre of characters. Thank you. that's another example of, you know, this premise of, you know, really working with story first. Here, you know, the backstories for the characters didn't exist. They're really this disparate group of applications, and each one had a, you know, had a character that was voiced in the user's own voice. So, you know, how do you bring that to video, and how do you make it really interesting and compelling for the audience? So that was just a little taste. It's coming. The last example is something that that we just rolled out and we'll be ramping up in the moms and family space. It's called The Daily Shot. And it's a program that's hosted by Allie Wentworth. Allie Wentworth, she's an author, she's a great humorist, and you know, you'll see from the video, she's also married to and lives with George Stephanopoulos. So that dynamic comes through in a very real way. It's neat because you know, if you contrast how smart and engaged this video is, you know, with the presentation, you know, which is really rough, informal, you know, Allie's in a very natural state. You really see where you know, where web video can go in contrast to the linear series. You know, this is as smart as the you know, Sunday morning news talking heads, but in a very natural environment. So we carved out a distribution with partnership with Yahoo to just bring this to the kind of the right aggregated audience. And the key takeaway here is that scripted TV, it's not always the answer. In digital, an authentic, more relatable, comedic experience often resonates better with the viewers. So let's take a look at The Daily Shot.
Morning. It's Wednesday, January 18th. I'm obsessed with this cruise ship story. Demi Moore has been hospitalized for exhaustion. Oh, I get it, sister. I would like to be hospitalized for exhaustion. Super Bowl. Is that who's playing?
There's four teams.
You're talking to a lady that doesn't watch sports and a gay man, so you're gonna get all your information.
Really?
Bye, George Stephanopoulos.
Thank you.
Bye.
In political news, Mr. Romney, he's now refusing to show his taxes until April, which will be after the primaries. What is he hiding?
Juju, did you know that O.J. Simpson,
yes,
he has a house in Tampa, Florida?
Yes.
What, are you going to leave? Are you going to go to Tampa?
Is that my husband?
Don't call me when I'm doing my show. I don't call you when you're doing your show.
Excuse me, can I talk to you for a second?
So as important as it is to tell great stories, even more important is really knowing your audience. As an example in the tweens segment, you know, we know a couple things about tweens. We know that they're constantly seeking opportunities for self-expression. If any of you have teenage children, you know that. And seeking the opportunity to be creative. And we've actually merged these very important tween drives in an area in our site called Create. And what Create is really a suite of online tools that allow kids and tweens to create you know, anything from an animated character to a drawing to, you know, a series of stamps. And the Create portal's really been successful at bringing these things together. It's a very active community that uses art as a social medium. One of the interesting things about Create is the audience always gives us the direction. You know, notwithstanding that we haven't built the tool, if they have a need, they'll figure out a way to satisfy that need. So, you know, we've seen polls run, contests, you know, commentary of film, all these things in the context of a product that really wasn't designed for that. And in many cases, we followed the audience. So we actually built a contest area and a contest tool to allow kids to create contests in that environment, because that's where they were going. And they can do all this in a safe, moderated environment. And to date, nearly 14 million pieces of art have been created within the Create portal and are preserved in our gallery. We believe it's one of the largest collections of kids' art on the planet. However, notwithstanding the success, we saw the opportunity to actually bring video to the Create experience by allowing kids to, you know, with a few clicks and a few movements, to produce kind of professional level quality video mashups. And we merged that with, you know, a very popular celebrity among tweens in Selena Gomez. So let's take a look. And what you're going to see is something that one of our kids actually produced within the Create portal and published into the gallery. And we brought it here to share with you today. Who says you're not perfect? Who says you're not worth it? Who says you're the only one that's hurting? Trust me, that's the price of beauty. Who says you're not pretty? Who says you're not beautiful? Who says? So that Selena video in the video event attracted more than 4.6 million visitors. So it's tremendously popular. Going forward, we're going to launch a mobile app, you know, which takes this video mashup functionality to mobile platforms. It still publishes into our gallery. And we're really excited when we imagine the possibilities for brand integration and for, you know, allowing kids to create their own movie trailers for priority movie releases we have at Disney. So Disney Channel is a leader in reaching the tweens, and we're very proud to have just launched a completely new experience for Disney Channel Online. And the goal was to make an online destination that was more relevant for daily visitation, so kids come back every single day, and to make a lifestyle destination for tweens. Some of the key features which you see in the comp here are, you know, really having inline video viewing and game experience and commenting and shout-outs. And this is the early results are looking pretty good for this. We're looking to build upon last year's success, the Blockbuster UGC event, which we invited fans to, you know, express themselves through dance in connection with Shake It Up, all under the Make Your Mark brand. And this is another example of how explosive it can be when you give your audience what they want. It resulted in more than 30,000 video submissions. And when you think about what it takes to actually get UGC video by a kid onto the site, it's remarkable, you know, because it involves parental consent and all the production things. So this is incredibly engaged, an incredibly high bar for 30,000 kids to jump over. And so let's just take a look at a clip from Make Your Mark and Shake It Up.
Make Your Mark, the ultimate dance-off.
Shake It Up Edition!
A multi-platform Disney Channel event where kids from across the nation submitted their dance audition videos for the chance to be a featured dancer on Shake It Up in Disney Channel's first ever dance competition. Nearly 30,000 videos were submitted during our online UGC contest and grassroots events.
So I'm here to make my mark.
Over 68 million views online, Make Your Mark instantly became a nationwide media sensation.
Behind the scenes at Make Your Mark, the ultimate dance-off, Shake It Up Edition.
Holding its first ever open dance competition.
Somebody can win a chance to be on the show.
It's going to be really cool to see all these up-and-comers and doing what they love and be passionate about it.
What do we have to do to get Mario on the show?
It'd be really cool if he could come and be a guest judge.
Aw, anytime, girls.
Six finalists were chosen. Competing for the ultimate prize.
A chance to appear on Disney Channel as a featured dancer on Shake It Up.
All leading up to the special two-night Make Your Mark television event, where votes from viewers at home would decide the winner.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Make Your Mark, the ultimate dance-off.
Hosted by Disney Channel stars.
Thank you guys for rocking the stage like you do.
Along with celebrity judges.
There wasn't a moment where I looked away.
I might hire you one day.
That was sick.
Featuring amazing performances. Plus other special celebrity appearances.
Congratulations on being the finalist.
Congratulations. I can't wait to see you make your mark.
This is Will I Am. I heard you be killing it on the dance floor.
This star-studded television event was watched by over 12 million viewers, delivering more kids than American Idol and So You Think You Can Dance.
The winner of Disney Channel's first ever dance competition, Make Your Mark, is...
Make Your Mark's combined presence on television, online, and Radio Disney gave our sponsors maximum multimedia exposure.
Dreams do come true.
Now, get ready for this year. America's Make Your Mark is going to shake it up even bigger. With even more stars, more amazing performances, incredible talent, all supported by a summer concert tour with Disney Channel stars, major retail participation, and products including Make Your Mark CDs and DVDs. So get ready to make your mark this year.
Only on Disney Channel.
So the next thing's really about adapting to the environment. You know, what does that mean? You know, that means really keeping our eye on the ball, understanding constantly, you know, what's happening out there with technology and changing behaviors. You know, and also surmounting the bar that we've set for ourselves at Disney. You know, Disney demands that you bring the magic every single time. And we need to ensure that we adapt our video content to do that by focusing on the guest experience and taking advantage of what's possible. You know, we have a network on Facebook of over 300 million plus fans. That's incredible responsibility, but at the same time, we have constant challenges about how to, you know, explore new ways of delivering content there and our adaptations. One of the ways we did this in a very powerful way, in a very magical way, in a very Disney way, was an event that we hosted in Times Square, which really brought the wonder of augmented reality, you know, both to the street, you know, and to web video. So let's take a look at this. To deliver, you know, dancing and laughing and loving with, you know, with the kids' favorite Disney characters, you know, it's a pretty incredible thing to be able to do. And last, I want to talk about just, you know, reaching our audience everywhere. We find them where they are now. You know, we're not a walled garden anymore. You know, hiding behind Disney.com. We look for all points distribution method for our content, whether it's through connected TV, where we're now on Roku, on Yahoo Connected TV, on Xbox Live, and on our new Disney on YouTube network, which just launched recently. It's a great example of how we're really extending that reach. We're in soft launch right now as we ramp up. And Disney on YouTube really provides a great opportunity for us to address a 13-plus audience. It's a different and complementary audience to the audience we have on Disney.com. But more importantly, it fills a void that YouTube has, and many of you who are parents get this, a void that YouTube has in terms of family entertainment experience in a really safe and trusted environment. What we have on the network is a short-form originals, long-form content, contextually relevant licensed content, and uploaded fan content. Those last two categories are critically important and kind of revolutionary for Disney. You know, it's this idea of inviting our audience to become a part of Disney. And it's been hard to do that before. But now we recognize that there's Disney-worthy content. There's stuff that's heartwarming and funny and sweet and wonderful. And even if it's not made by us, it deserves to be on our channel. And there's also Disney-related content. You know, so there's a wealth of video of men and women proposing to their intendeds, you know, in the park and on a ride, or even in one case by flash mob in downtown Disney. And that's the video that we want to have and that we want to present and share within this YouTube experience. As a very last piece, I want to share with you a way of, you know, how we change the way we can execute campaigns. We look at this great narrative that we developed with, you know, these Muppets characters who, you know, are all very close to our hearts. If any of you grew up during the time when the Muppets were first popular, I'm sure, and I hope many of you enjoyed, you know, taking your kids to reintroduce them to this experience of the new Muppets movie. So behind this, you know, we had this new Muppets movie going to DVD release, and Procter & Gamble had some needs around a bounty campaign. And this was a great way of bringing this together and I think in a most appropriate way, in a way that's exceedingly engaging for the audience. So this is one of the three videos that was created for the campaign. So let's run that video.
Brought to you by Bounty.
Hi, old.
Hi.
Welcome to the party. Come on in.
Hi.
I want you to meet our entertainment for the party. The absolutely incredible and totally inexplicable Great Gonzo. Gonzo, what are you doing?
Balancing a pole on my head.
What's that on top of the pole?
Oh, it's a great white shark swimming in a bucket of finger paint.
A great white shark swimming in a bucket of finger paint? Isn't that dangerous?
Not as long as I don't get distracted. Oh. Hey, good looking.
Well, it's not that easy being clean, but luckily, we're ready. Gonzo, where's the shark?
I don't know. He'll turn up in the end.
But...
Ooh, there's something you don't see every day.
You want to bet?
Now that's what I call trap and lock. Hey, Frog, bring it!
Brought to you by Bounty Paper Towels with Trap and Lock Technology, so you can clean the mess with less. The Muppets on Blu-ray combo packs and DVD in stores now.
So anyway, I thought that was a really great example of, you know, how, like, in an organic and natural way, you know, without disrupting the humor or the entertainment premise, you know, that we brought a brand in to kind of solve the literal mess that the Muppets had created. And I think that worked out very well. So just in summary, our strategy is rooted in telling great stories, telling stories audiences want to hear, and doing it in a simple, clear fashion that's really appropriate to the medium, knowing our audience, listening to them, and incorporating what we know and what we learn to let them guide us to creating new experiences, and really adapting to the environment, you know, always looking to see, you know, what's the most magical thing that exists out there that we can bring to our experience on Disney.com and beyond, and to reach our audience everywhere. They don't have to come to us. You know, we will find them where they are, and we will deliver to them, you know, the right content at the right time in the right place. So thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed this, and it's a great opportunity for me because it is so fun and inspiring to work at Disney, and I hope you guys got a little bit of that. And it's great to work with people like Renee Santaella, who is my partner in crime and a great colleague. And if you have any questions, you know, please come up and ask me or ask Renee. We're happy to answer them. So thank you very much for this time. I appreciate it.
Thank you, Mark.